What if you could master this simple technique and design your own destiny to gain control of your little voice? The possibilities are unlimited. There will be no more sabotaging your dreams or any barriers to your success or even getting stuck by any roadblocks or obstacles. How would that sound to you? Hi, I'm Dana Huang. Today I'm going to share with you using these 21 simple power techniques by Blair Singer Little Voice Mastery Program. So the first skill I would like to share with you is being pleasant. Why is being pleasant so important for any people that is doing sales? The reason is because that being pleasant and to be a great listener is the first step to closing the deal. Because being a great listener and being pleasant, listening to your clients, what are their problems, you will be able to give them the best solutions that they need or want. So how to learn the skill of being pleasant? Okay, so there's two ways. So either if you have a partner, okay, you sit knee to knee facing with that partner and eyeball to eyeball, look into each other's eyes for 3 minutes without blinking your eyes or looking somewhere else. The second way is by looking through the mirror, okay, if you don't have anyone to partner with you. During these 3 minutes, minimum 3 minutes, and during these 3 minutes, what you will experience if you do this multiple times, and you will notice that magical moments and ideas starts to come by. So be prepared to accept and acknowledge all these great ideas that's coming into your mind, because this is the best moment that you could ever have when you are only being pleasant. So the second technique I'm going to share with you is debrief. So you can do this with your team, or you can ask these questions to yourself as well. So there's 4 questions we can actually ask ourselves or with our team, okay? So let's assume you have a project or you have a goal and you didn't finish on time, or the mission didn't end up with what you have in mind. So you can ask yourself what had happened, what worked, what didn't work, and how could you make it better? What did you learn? So these are a few questions you can start asking yourself so that you recognize all the mistakes or doesn't go as planned as what you have planned for. Remember, there's no mistakes that cannot be learned. All mistake is gifted. Mistake is the ladder to success. So embrace it and start to turn it to success. So the third technique will be goal settings. So often when we set a certain goal, it's either we achieve it or we didn't achieve it. So I'll give you an example. If you set to earn a revenue of 100K for end of the 12 months, but in the end, let's say you only get the revenue of 90,000. So is it a failure to you? Well, why all failures is the ladder to success? First of all, you will have 2 thoughts. The first one could be, perhaps you will think about setting your goals much lower. So in the first place, you might thought maybe I should set 90,000 instead of 100,000. Or perhaps you will be thinking about setting lower your expectations, or eventually all your achievements and your confidence levels will also become lower. Or you can look into another aspect, which is what did you learn in the process, and begin to write them down or to share with your friends or even do a recording. So whichever steps that you do be more aware of your tonality, your facial expression. For example, your eyes or your face become brightened up. Some of the positive vibes around you. The reason is because you have to acknowledge all the unacknowledged. And because of this, you will be able to slowly identify what is the real reason of the goal that you set for. So for my own experience, setting goal is very important. Without a goal, you will not be able to visualize it and to see it every day in front of you. So how to set a goal that you can achieve it? First of all, is to set something that is really realistic. And after you have set a goal, be realistic and break them down into from bigger chunks, break them down into smaller sections. Just as though you cannot eat a gigantic elephant at one go. So by breaking them down and be more realistic with your goal settings, you will tend to be able to achieve your goals much easier. So the four techniques I'm going to share with you, which is one of my favorites also, is how to handle success. To handle success is, as the words mentioned, success. So it could be celebrate all small wins. How do we celebrate? As long as you acknowledge that is something that, you know, is a small win, you start by doing this. Putting your fists together and just say yes. Or, you know, for example, a lot of athletes, before they start their competition, they will always mumble to themselves, like, for example, I don't know what they mumble, maybe they start to say, oh, I can do it, you know, they start to say all the positive thoughts that comes to their mind that can really help them to create a positive environment, you know, because often the inner voice will start to chippering into their ears again and maybe start to mumble, Diana, you cannot do it, I cannot do it, I told you so, you're going to fail or something like that. So we have to start to train our mind to celebrate all this success by pepping ourselves. Every small little success, we would have to try to reward ourselves, even by a simple pat. Like say, Diana, you have done great, that's a great move, or something like that. It's a celebration. Or if you feel something like, you know, a more physical and really have a punch into your mind is some actions, yes? So you could be like doing some, your hand is like your fist tied together and you just point to the sky and say, yes! You know, that kind of momentum, the kind of spirit. And after you know, manage to do this couple of times, and your body will start to acknowledge this is success. So the next one I'm going to share with you is how to handle adversity or handle failures. So how to make use of our success in treating our failures. So the fifth technique I'm going to share with you is to handle adversity. So to handle adversity is to simply handle objections. So what to do when your client say no to you? So to handle adversity is actually the opposite of to handle success. So to handle success is to celebrate all small wins, to take claims. But to handle adversity is not to accept any claims that is not going to be beneficial to you. So for example, when your client say no to you, it's really not to say no to you. They are saying no to perhaps your programs or to, you know, to their feelings on that day. They don't feel quite right at that moment, or it could be saying no to your price. So don't take it personally. In fact, what you should do is perhaps you should think of another way of improving. Maybe you could tweak a few ways to improve your presentations, or perhaps you could change a few slides or images to make your presentation looks better. So these are the things that you can start to do to revise your presentation to make it better. So if that is the cause of the reason. So the next step is, how do we really start to change and accept and grow every small success, even though we meet some difficulties in life? So take every small step to live better every day, so that we can start to train our mind, our soul, even our inner voice that is chipping every day. So if you start to be more aware of what your inner voice is trying to tell you, it's all about your fear. It's all about your emotions. So once you identify all the different emotions that you have and be more aware of the presence and to be more aware of what they are telling you, so whatever inner voice they are trying to tell you, just be aware and learn to how to handle them correctly. Never try to escape or avoid any circumstances. Be there to face it and challenge it. Be more conscious and thought about it. Do not start to build all the negative thoughts or feelings around you, because it will not do you any better. So I hope what I had shared with you, Blair Singer Little Voice Mastery Program, had helped me tremendously in improving my inner voice. So I hope what I have shared with you can help you one way and another. So I will be sharing more with you about Blair Singer's mastery program. So if you are interested, do take note at the comments or the description below. All these 21 techniques are golden nuggets to me. To practice even one of the techniques can help you tremendously in your business and your life. If you like what I'm sharing, do click on the link somewhere below and stay connected so that I can update you with the future recordings. And thank you. I will see you soon again.